course of the day, the Tasmanian team joins, and all of a sudden, Dylan's like super invested for some reason. It's like very unexpected. Fucking devils, yes!
Yeah, Tassie devils! Oi, oi! He's gonna be all about it one day.
Believe me.
I hope you're like, if one day you have kids, that.
Was there a pause or a full stop?
No, I was just trying to work out how I would. I hope that they are like a sports prodigy.
Yeah.
But I mean, the thing is, even if I had a kid who was a sports prodigy, it's not like I don't feel like I'm equipped. It's not like I'm so inept to sport that I'm unable to handle that. I just don't care about football.
But you'd have to start caring.
Yeah, but like if I had a son who was like, man, let's go kick the footy, son. No.
Let's go kick the footy, son. Damn, that's a power move.
Yeah. I know how it works. Handball. Catch that bad boy. Got to bounce it. What? At one point, if it hits the goal, if it hits the ball, you know, like, I know the rules, right? You mark it, you have to stop. Then there's a dude who stands in front of you going, for some fucking reason. Really, yeah. the thing I feel about football, and this is my hot take for why I personally could never get back into it. It is a game that I think Australians like to believe is, this is a real hot take. This may be my biggest take yet. It is a game that I think Australians like to believe is this real, like, macho, Aussie-spirited, like, fucking full-on game. But it's pretty fucking weak. Like, like, anytime I watch it now and it's like someone just like happens to get pushed over, it's like, oh, like, you know, suddenly the fucking ambulance is out there and whatever. I'm like, I don't know, guys. You like to act like this is, you know, this is like a full-on sport. Like, this is pretty fucking into it. But I don't know if it's by cause of the AFL or, you know, just 2024 and, you know, you're not allowed to injure people anymore. But pretty fucking soft these days.
Wow, I didn't know we were talking to an ex-footy player from the 80s, you know? Talking about how it used to be back in his day.
It used to be. Fucking used to have CTE and concussion for breakfast. Fuck you, now.
I mean, is it not? I'm sure I'm saying stuff that is not a hot take, but I don't partake in those things for sports media. But, like, is it not, like, at a certain... It's the same as, like, I'm going to...
No, like, the biggest problem... So the biggest problem at the moment in AFL isn't... Is the AFL itself being too worried about lawsuits? And like the big thing in like the people who have sued AFL about like their head injuries and long term difficulties after playing, all of them have really been like, it's not about the game, it's about how I was looked after, like during the game and after it and stuff like that. What the AFL has done have been like, well, we need to change this so that like if somebody hits their head and hurts themselves, that it's not our fault. It's not our fault. We've done things to protect you. It's like, no. You just need to put in place good systems that help players get through it. The players know what they're doing, they know the position they're putting themselves in, they know the possibility for head injuries. It is just you're just needing to be putting in systems around them to support them to make sure they're going to be okay in the long run. That's all that is. And the AFL have just gone a whole fucking overboard. That's all it is. It's like that's the big issue at the moment.
Because bringing it back to something else a little bit more in my wheelhouse, it's like, did you see the chair shot from AEW last week? Right. Did you not see this? So it's Briscoe.
How can you tell? Don't they have chair shots every single like 10 minutes in AEW?
fucking like whacked Jack Perry. He was like up. He like his arms were, like, tied into the barbed wire.
Yeah, and he smacked him in the head with it. Yeah.
Smacked him in the head. Now it's a gimmick chair, but people are still fucking freaking the fuck
sure
out.
Sure, you didn't scream over. Real chair.
Well, no, they've said it was a gimmick chair, but like, but this is the other thing where this is also how I feel about like, I'm like, I definitely feel like for wrestling, it's like, yes, there's a lot of changes that are better, like, you know, CTE, whatever, like don't do chair shots anymore, that makes sense. But at a certain stage, I feel like there's a danger to it, like, stop, like,
but the thing is, at a certain point, it is, as long as, like, I think all it has to be, as long as the two people involved in the spot are signing off on it and are both agreeing to it and are happy with it. And if they have to sign some kind of legal document to be like, yes, we have approved this, we are happy with all the precautions being taken, we're happy with the situation, yes. Then I think the biggest worry for, like, companies, especially in a very litigious way, is, well, two things. I guess one, it's like they don't want people kind of creating the spots at home. But the other is they don't want, you know, Jack Perry 20 years down the line all of a sudden being like, AEW caused my head injury, and like, yeah, trying to sue him for, or, the
his family.
Back around. Mm. Yeah, so it's it is what it is at the moment.
I also feel like the other thing is, like, it's just because of the age of the internet, everyone's like a fucking Twitter doctor, everyone has the opinion. You know,
and it's like, I don't want to go into it, but like all the stuff with
was that face, Ash? What?
No, it's just the way that this all worked around. One of the biggest stories in,
yeah, I was just about to weave week. It in. I was just about to weave it. Like, I don't want to go too far into it because I think it's
talking
such
about
a
people being soft and someone forfeiting because they got hit in the face this week.
Oh, that fucking the Olympic boxer.
Yeah,
mm-hmm. Yeah. What a fucking what? And, hey, let me say for that,
it all weaved in. You know, people being too soft. Everybody being a Twitter doctor, you know?
Yeah. Well, I'm gonna say this. A, that what the one in blue shorts, right? Blue shorts went down, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And then cried. It's a man.
She didn't. No, but like the lady in the blue shorts didn't do that.
Or basically hinted at it.
She didn't even interviews. Like, if in all the interviews after it, if you really listen to what she's saying, she's more talking about she just has never been hit like that before. And that
everybody just took it that way.
And everybody has just interpreted that as this Italian lady accusing the other person of being trans when it's not the case whatsoever. And like the person, like, it's this story is,
I saw a clip from her from like the 2020 Olympics, and here's what I think for her. She should not be a boxer. She sucks. Like, yeah. I've seen,
like she shouldn't be. And
you get the punch in the face several times. With your hands by your side, that's not a good sign.
Yeah,
as a boxer,
like, yeah, you're like, good lord.
It's like,
was there no one else?
Like, you look at it in the terms of the big situation where it's like, okay, what's being twisted as this person was trans and they should have, is just a biologically born woman who has a naturally high amount of testosterone in her system, which is a known occurrence and disease in people. It's the same as, so now people say, well, she shouldn't be fighting, she shouldn't be in the part of it, and it's like, well, are you going to do the same thing to a man? If a man steps into a ring and he's got low testosterone, are you going to tell him he can't box other men, he has to go box women?
It's more like everybody keeps bringing up Michael Phelps said lungs that were 20% larger lung capacity. Should he be banned because he has a physical advantage?
No.
Should Thorpey have been banned because he had really large feet so he could kick better? You know?
Like it's ridiculous.
Okay.
He's obviously a giant, not a man.
And I think it is the idea of, I think this idea of, especially in the world, of course that whole conversation is being twisted by transphobes and people wanting to push that agenda for their benefit. So, and that's them being twisted.
People who say, The crowd that usually says they're sick of trans people pushing their agenda on people is pushing their agenda on people.
Yes. And you know, it's like, it's just stuff like that. And like, yeah, I think it's frustrating. And I think there's so much of it is, I really hate this, participationism and like fair play that's come into the world, but like to an overextent that's like, you know, I think it's fucking ridiculous that at like kids' football games, they don't keep track of the score in certain sports anymore, especially in America. What? Like they don't keep track of the score.
Well, they do certain age groups.
Certain like, age
at
groups.
At the very beginning.
Nah.
They don't keep track of the score.
I can understand and that for like 6 year olds.
I get it for like Auskick, totally get it, right?
Oh yeah, if it's not a competition.
If it's not a competition, 100%. That's completely fine. You know, I've watched kids playing Auskick when I'm at the footy and they turn around and like kick it into their own goals and stuff. Like it's you know. But when it's like an actual competition, there are winners and losers. And I think the idea of winners and losers and that competitiveness is being drilled out of people because they think everybody should be celebrated, or just because somebody lost to another person, they both should celebrate. You know, there shouldn't be a loser. That everybody, and it's like I fucking hate it. It's like it is so frustrating because.
Sorry, I just thought of a meme and.
Oh my god!
So I just pictured those two. You can go back to your back. Oh, I just pictured those two boxes and the one that won that match is Mario and punches Sonic in the face and Sonic falls over.
Ah! Oh my god. No, I don't even laughing at the meme because you explained it so poorly.
You had the meme in my head, man. You had the meme in my head.
Sonic's like, I didn't win because it's a man. It wasn't a hedgehog.
Yeah, it's me.
Like it's yeah. Shit's dumb. Shit's very dumb.
It's extra dumb because she was Italian. So I mean, it's just...
my god.
Yeah. No, I'm sort of sick of seeing stuff about it, to be honest, because I think the other thing that drives me up the wall is I'm like, I think everyone who believes that. She could be trans, like, and this is like taking any and all like the argument of should trans people be allowed to participate in their now whatever, like that they're affirming gender sport, whatever, taking that argument completely out of it because it doesn't even matter for this because it's two females, like born female, so it doesn't even matter. I think the fact that people believe that person could have been trans and picked, even though they're from a country that would probably
one of like, the most conservative countries in the world.
Yeah, yes. Like fucking never allow that. Like, I'm like, are you for real? Like, how dumb do you have to be? Pretty dumb. That's why JK Rowling's.
Oh, God. Is that dumb fucking. Oh, she's all over it. I'm like, you need to just go away.
She's all over it. Piers Morgan. All the rest of them.
Elon Musk.
Elon Musk.
Yeah.
The same week that fucking I saw Grimes was going to court trying to win custody of their children. I'm like, because one of them's trans or whatever. I don't know. I'm like, yeah. Good luck to you, dude. All right, Ciaran, tell me about the tattoo. Walk us through it.
Oh, yeah. I got that, didn't I?
Did anybody permanently alter their body this week?
Yeah, it was me. Yeah, I got a tattoo on my leg. It looks pretty fantastic. It was done by...
Not anime at all. Just want to clarify.
Not anime at all. I finally got my tattoo done. I've talked about this on the show, this feeling of wanting one. I got it by sick_tattoo or Marius, which you can find him on Instagram. Yeah, I think it looks amazing. Like, it was awesome. It looks really good. I've loved the design. I did a 5-hour session.
What is the picture for people who don't know?
I've tweeted it and it's on Instagram and stuff. But it is a picture of Kakashi Hakate from Naruto coming out of a kunai with like lightning and shit. And it's his fox mask and stuff on it. It came out really well. Coloring is amazing. As I said, 5-hour session, was fine. It was good. It was great. I enjoyed it. I think I was falling asleep through a number of parts of it, like it, the pain. And of course, right, I'll say this now that I'm the expert of one tattoo. I will say for anybody who's thinking about getting a tattoo, has always wanted one or wanted one, the pain isn't that bad. As long as you choose a good spot in your body to do it that isn't as painful, you take advice and you listen to what your tattoo artist says, you pick a good tattoo artist, and yeah, it was yeah, it was a good experience overall. I'm like, I was already late there.
What did you do for 5 hours?
I listened to some podcasts. I talked with Marius a bit. I almost fell asleep a number of times. I watched some anime. It was a little annoying because I was like layover. Like,
did you watch Naruto while getting?
I thought about it. I thought it'd be funny, but no, I didn't. That'd be yeah, no, no, I did not. But like, it was good. It was good just to chill out and not do much. Like, it's yeah. Like the it starts off and you go, oh, okay, that's a different sensation. And then as soon as it gets into it, it's normal. It got a bit tender towards the end of it. Like towards the end of the piece, like the back end of the 5 hours, like you did get very tender. But overall, like I was already lay there, like into being like, yeah, I could book in for my next one already. Like this is.
So you're a tattoo guy now?
Yeah, I think so. I think I'm really definitely, not even I think so. Like I'm definitely getting more. Like I'm already thinking that Monday after PAX, I'm already in Melbourne with a day off. I could get something like semi-small at some point on the Monday. Like I could leave the hotel Monday morning. Get? Pardon?
What are you thinking?
I have no fucking clue though at the moment.
You've got 2 months to figure it out.
Yeah, I got 2 months to figure it out, but it's like,
do you want to get a penguin?
Classic. yeah, so I'll probably go do that. Book in for that Monday.
Get Explosion Network tattooed on you and then we'll rebrand.
No, just Ian. Ian's fine.
There was that time I was very close to getting my first.
After you get
the Explosion Network, I was very close to getting my first tattoo at the same time. I don't know if anyone recalls. I said like we didn't quite reach what I was only like a few hundred dollars off, I think. Whatever, but I was going to get hashtag every trophy counts. Which honestly, if I'd got, still wouldn't regret.
Still wouldn't regret.
No.
But no, it's yeah, I'm excited to get more. I am very much. I think I want to get at least probably two more before the end of the year, and then next year working on a sleep.
You're like playing catch up.
Yeah, I don't know. It's just something there. I'm like, yeah, I can fucking, like, it's not. And even like the next one, like that one on the Monday, I don't want to go. I'm not going to go anything as big as this time. I just want to do some small stuff on my arm.
Yeah, because you got like
it's like
the knee down to your ankle bone, right?
To my ankle. Yeah, yeah. Like the whole outside of my calf is done in that one sitting. Like 5 hours is not the normal length of time for somebody's first tattoo. Like that is very much me probably going overboard a little bit with the amount of detail and coloring and everything that was done. I definitely recommend.
How do your parents feel about it?
Yeah, they're good about it. They make, you know, they both. I've had, it's really funny actually. For the people I show it to, anybody who is like youngish or like, not youngish anymore because I'm not even young, but like around my age or lower, everybody's, oh, that's sick, that's so cool, blah, 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 blah. Anybody who's older, like a couple of my people I work with that are like in their like 60s, and even my mum are like.
I like how that's that. Like, anyone around my age, like 30, and then 60. 60? It's like
just double.
They look at the fox mask and they're like, is that a pig? And I'm like, no, it's a Japanese fox mask. Like, you know, just trying to. They're like, nah, it looks like a pig. I'm like.
Nah, a pig has much more of a
distinct nose and stuff.
You know?
It's very like even like after it, like at the minute, it's a weird sensation having like I'm at the peeling stage at the moment. It's very weird having skin peel off that is the same color as the tattoo. Like it's like a shard of like at the minute, I'm like shard of blue skin, like it'll just peel off and I'm like, oh, okay. For it sinks in, but it's like it's at the minute, it's just like having sunburn on my leg. That's all it is. And I've just, you know, I only have to have it wrapped the first day and then aired it out over the weekend. And then for last week and then for another week, I've got a cream. I put on it twice a day just to make sure it heals nicely. But yeah, I'm excited for more. I, yeah, very much am a tattoo guy now and I'm all about it.
How much did it set you back?
It was $700 all up. So I was fine with that.
What's it all up? Like, is there, do you have a cost with no ink and then they add an ink cost?
Well, no, I guess it takes on how large you go, how many hours a session is.
So if you'd said, because I don't know how this works, but if you'd said, I want the same tattoo, but I want to do it in three sessions, would it cost you more or less?
I have no idea on that one.
Do you know, but
probably guess, I don't know. I would guess more.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. Surely
I'd probably guess more, right? Because you'd have to. That's more of their day. They're booking out. Like, it's very funny, actually. Like, he even asked me, like Marius even asked me before I started. He's like, "How's your pain tolerance? Like, how is?" And I'm like, oh, "I'm pretty good. Like, I don't see myself any issues with this. I could see how some people that like would need to take more breaks. The only reason I took, like, I think we only took two or three breaks, and the only reason was so Marius could get some more paints, colors, and so I could stretch because of the position I was laying in was probably like I was a contortionist a little bit. But other than that, I had a really good experience, like a great experience. It's I couldn't talk more positively about this experience, to be honest.
Mm. Very good. Well, I'm glad because, you know, you come on here months ago with a big idea and who's to know where it was going to go?
I know, right? Like, so it would have been, and that was probably the only thing, like, I wasn't even nervous going into the session. The only thing I was nervous about was, like, well, the only thing that started was, like, okay, what if, like, the first moment is, like, I just can't take the pain? Like,
what if you discover in that moment you really don't like nips?
Yeah, exactly, right? Like, it's what if in this moment I just decide this isn't for me, I don't like the pain and stuff. It's and then it started and I was like, and I'd read places where they were like, you know what, the start is generally the worst bit. And it's like, oh, okay, you just build up adrenaline. It was really funny because I drank, one of the things I'd read was like, oh, hydrate. And so it's about a 2-hour drive from where I live to Melbourne for the tattoo place. So in that time, I drank like 1.5 liters of water. So and then
did you just need to consistently piss while you were...
Not so bad. The worst bit was me like parking where I was. It's on a busy street in Hawthorne. And so I found a park in the end and I was like, it's a 2-hour park. I'm just going to run the risk. Fuck it. If I get a ticket, I get a ticket, whatever. Because at that point I was like, A, I've got like 20, 25 minutes until my appointment time. But B, my God, do I need a piss real fucking badly. And there's me walking up and down. And then I was like, first thing first, I don't want to just walk into the tattoo place and be like, hey, I got a piss. So I was like, so like, I like walked up and down this street, like for like, and I was like, I went into the petrol station there. They're like, nah, you can go to this place. And that place was closed. And then in the end, I did have to go in, get all like the start of it, figure out the sizing and stuff. And then before we started, I was like, oh, I just need it. I managed to like, but that was, it was touch and go when I was driving. When I was driving, there were some real bad moments. Right. Question. I was like,
well, when it was like at some point, like, because you would have looked at the clock and be like, oh, I'm ready. Like, I've got time. Yeah. Wouldn't you just like,
I don't that know, was the other McDonald's thing, right?
Is yes. I don't know. Like
yes, yeah. I should have just been like, I should pull over and, but at the same time, it's, you know, it's in me. It's part of my genetics probably because my parents are always super early to things to be like, I'll get to somewhere super ridiculously early. And it's also me where it's like the store, as far as I knew, the place didn't open until the same time as my appointment.
What day was this also?
A Friday.
Okay.
So I was like, oh, okay, fuck. Like, I'm going to. And then I was like, oh, I could have walked in earlier. It was, everybody was just chilling, waiting for people. And like, some people had already started tattooing before I even got in there.
What time was it?
It was 11 o'clock in the morning. Yeah. So, yeah, there was already people starting and stuff. What was really funny is
did they have
a
key to get into the toilet or did they have a bodyguard or like...
Actually, no, but I did have... So I have a... I wouldn't say it's an undeserved fear, but you know what? Toilets that have a door that go from floor to ceiling... Or, like, they don't have a gap in it. Like, you know how toilet cubicles normally have a gap either way. But, you know, toilets in small businesses or something, like, there's just, like, a normal fucking door that is completely closed.
Well, it's most tattoo places are just, like,
a apartment building, right? Exactly, right? Yeah. So, when I have the fear, just in general, of getting locked in one of those, like of just like going in, and it was just like, almost happened to me in this tattoo parlor, where like the lock just wouldn't go back out, like wouldn't unlock, and I was like, oh, this is the worst. I was like, this was like the second or third piss. I was like, part of the way through the tattoo, that's me like semi panicking with it. Eventually, after like 30 seconds of me panicking, like finally managed to get it open, but I was like, oh boy, fuck me, like just. Not for me. I was expecting me to have to. I was always, as soon as this starts happening, I'm like, I'm picturing myself being like, hello, help.
Would you yell out or would you like call someone?
No, I would have to yell out because, like, yeah. I guess in the tattoo parlor, I didn't really know anybody. Like, it's very funny. It was a very weird experience. Like, I'd only spoken to Marius over emails and stuff. I never met him. I knew nobody in this tattoo parlor. To be honest, before I even walked into this place, I didn't even know what kind of tattoo parlor it was. I didn't know what it looked like inside.
You thought a bunch of bikies and stuff? Like.
No, but I was like, you know, I don't. All I had was this. It was a recommendation from Brendan over it. Is it still 8-bit? I was going to say 8-bit, but then...
Brendan, yeah. From Brendan White.
Brendan White, yeah.
Brendan White Productions.
Brendan White, yeah. Productions. Brendan had given me the recommendation. It's actually really funny because Marius, when I was getting ready, he goes, oh, who is now, your friend?
Hold on. You're going too fast. Now, the recommendation is based on, like, he got tattoos there when he was in Melbourne, or he just...
Well, he lives in Melbourne, so...
when I met the dude like 10 years ago, his whole body was covered in tats. When has he got another one? He has no room.
He's got, no, but this is, okay, this is part of my story. He's gotten more. And like, because this one of them, Brendan's actually said to me, I'm so jealous of you that you are a blank slate, that you could just do whatever the fuck you want. He's like, I'm jealous. I wish that was me still. But no, when I actually got in there, Marius is like, oh, who recommended you for me? Like, it's really cool. And I was like, oh, Brendan. And he goes, oh, Brendan. And then I quickly like flicked up Twitter and like showed Brendan's profile picture. He goes, oh, fuck, Brendan. I literally tattooed him yesterday. He's like, it's so funny. He's like, I tattooed him yesterday and I showed him your tattoo design without him knowing it was going to be on you and without me knowing that he knew you.
That's funny.
So that was me laughing because, like, yeah, obviously Brendan and Marius had a conversation the day before because they had like a 10-hour session or something on Brendan's piece. Like, Brendan's piece from Violent Evergarden was fucking amazing. And if Brendan had asked, oh, what are you doing tomorrow? And he's shown him the piece that's done on my leg. It's so fucking funny, like, just how coincidental. Like, I hadn't mentioned to Brendan that I'd booked in. I hadn't mentioned to Brendan what day I was going, like, nothing. It was just pure coincidence. So
Brendan gave you the recommendation, but you never actually told him that you was taking up his recommendation?
No, not at all. Like, because Brendan had given me, like,
have you told him since? Or?
Yeah, no, I literally messaged him and we were talking about it and stuff. And, like,
it's funny.
It's so fucking funny. Like, it's just, like, it was just, it all kind of came into effect and played around. And, yeah, but tattoos are great.
That is actually a very you story where you're like, ask someone for recommendation, take recommendation, book in with said recommendation person, and then like, it's, yeah, that's a very you story.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a very me story, apparently. Yeah. 100%, yeah.
Now, I just want to be honest, also, in a world where Ash got tattooed, that's 100% what Ash would also do.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like, there's some, like, yous are very different people at times. Certain things like that, I'm like, no, they would both do the exact same thing. Like.
So I look forward to one day you being all tatted up and it's like we're podcasting with Post Malone.
I think I'm not gonna be that bad. I think I'm gonna I guess at the moment you're fucking I think at the moment I'm just like semi just putting fun stuff on my right arm is probably my next thing, is to put a couple on my right arm, and then next year is like a sleeve on my left and just going from there and doing what I want. I had this like course I started having, I was like, man, I could get like my leg just be Naruto stuff. So that, like, I have Kakashi really now.
A whole leg.
I think I could, because I love the shit out of it. And I was like, you know, it'd be really fucking cool. Like, I have Kakashi on one side, which is one of Naruto's teachers. I could get Jiraiya on the other side of my calf. And then on the back, I could get Naruto. So it's like all three of them together. And then, yeah, I was just, I'm just riffing. I don't know if I will ever do that, but I'm very much riffing on ideas at the moment of just shit to do.
What would it take to get you a tattoo, Ash?
Money. and inspiration.
There's also, like, I'm also, I think I'm also at the point where I'll
hit up Brendan White to get you a recommendation.
Brendan gave me really good recommendations, to be honest. And, to be honest, for a first time, Marius was perfect. Everything was great. I was comfortable. I was relaxed. I think I'm now at the point as well after this where I was like, it's very funny, right? The reason I hadn't had a tattoo yet was because, as I've said previously, too much focus on I wanted, like, you know, sentimental value, or like I wanted to be like the perfect thing, yada, yada, yada. I'm now at the point where I think I've gone like completely 180, where, like, say for Marius, so I really like Marius's work and I've got him to be like, if he has some like designs that he hasn't put on people yet, they play, I could be like, yeah, just chuck that on me, put that somewhere cool. Like, I think I'm like kind of at that point of just being like, I just want cool designs and cool artwork put everywhere.
That's what art prints are for.
All right. On that note, that tattooed gun is shutting down. It's time to record RK Couch.
Also, minor thing. One of my thing was, sorry, let's not record RK Couch for a second. One of my big things was like, I was going to like be worried about the noise of the tattoo gun. Super fucking quiet now, at least these ones. Also, all of them fucking wireless. They're like fucking Ridgy Didge, fucking just wireless fucking.
Yeah, not like with a massive cable or whatever.
Yeah, no massive cable. No, nothing. Like, it was just, yeah, no, super cool. Yeah. Technology.